Gun control, Medicaid, and the federal budget deficit were some of the topics Senator Chuck Grassley addressed in his town hall meeting at Smokey Row on Tuesday. Senator Grassley fielded questions for an hour from a crowd of around 85 people. CRI's Eduardo Zamarripa was there too and had a chance to talk with Grassley after the meeting.
For more than 30 years, Senator Grassley has visited all 99 Iowa counties at least once a year. On Tuesday, it was Oskaloosa's turn to greet him on his tour. Grassley answered several questions regarding his stance on gun control. The Republican senator has opposed expanded background checks for gun sales, but has supported additional school safety measures. If the Democratic gun control bill manages to get approved in the Senate, Grassley is drafting an alternative bill that, in his opinion, does not violate constitutional rights and addresses gun violence.
Well, it's not even written yet, and for the most part, what's different about some of the bills we're going to have up it isn't going to have any background checks in it, any registration in it. It's not going to have any banning of guns. What we're trying to take care of is trafficking in guns and to make sure that schools that want to hire policemen, that they get some help from the federal government.
Grassley says the problem with background checks is you would need to have every gun registered for the checks to be effective. Doing that means the government would know where every gun in the United States is, something Grassley opposes because he says it infringes with the Second Amendment. On another topic, the Iowa senator answered questions from the public regarding Medicaid. States can expand Medicaid under federal health care reform. Supporters say that with Medicaid expansion, a higher number of Iowans would be covered. Opponents say it's unrealistic that the federal government could fulfill its promise to pay for Medicaid. In Iowa, an estimated 150,000 more Iowans would be covered under Medicaid expansion. Governor Terry Branstad has proposed his own plan that would cover an estimated 89,000 additional Iowans. Grassley says he agrees with governors who are concerned about Medicaid's cost and the ability of the federal government to help with that cost.
Let me say, not just about Governor Branstad, but about any governor that's suspicious about Congress keeping its word, that with a $17 trillion debt now and the budgets that are before Congress could expand that up to $25 trillion in just 10 years.
Grassley added that 4 years ago, when the Affordable Care Act was approved, the Congressional Budget Office estimated it would cost over $900 billion. He says so far it has cost about $2.7 trillion. Lastly, Grassley discussed the federal budget deficit. Grassley has criticized a proposed budget resolution because it does not actually make any cuts in spending. What it reduces is the amount of expected growth in spending, but not the amount of money spent each year. Grassley has opposed the budget resolution and hopes to get to a point where the national debt can be trimmed.
Because I tell everybody that asks about it, there's a bad answer and there's a worse answer. None of these answers are very satisfying to my constituents who believe that your federal government ought to be living within its budget. Hopefully we get back to the point where we were in 97 through the year 2000 when we paid down $568 billion on the national debt. But it's going to be a long time getting there.
Grassley also said that there is nothing negative to say about his county tour every year, other than the time it takes to do it. He said he hopes his appearances help ease public cynicism. For CRI Weekly News, I'm Eduardo Zamarripa.
Grassley also mentioned that he has written a letter to the Secretary of the Department of Homeland Security asking about why the DHS purchased more than 1.6 billion bullets last month without offering an explanation.